everyone. Welcome to FameWorld Educational Hub. Myself, Aishwarya Saxena, and today in the series of PHP and MySQL, I am going to start with the concept of for each loop. I have already discussed the conditional statements, that is selective statement. First, selective statement, and in the selective statement, we have discussed if else, nested if else. There are videos in this playlist for selective statement of switch case. After that, I started iterative statements, that is looping. And in looping, we discussed for loop. We saw the examples of for loop. We saw the examples of while loop, the syntax of while loop. We also saw do while loop with the syntax and examples. So I hope you have watched the previous videos and you have learned these concepts. You have practiced them by your own on your system. And if you haven't watched the previous lectures in this series, I recommend you to please watch those lectures, because it would be much more helpful for you to understand the concept if you have watched the previous lecture. Otherwise, you will get confused at what is happening and what is not. So here, in today's lecture, I am going to start with the concept of for each loop. So here, I am going to start with a new file. And here, in the new file, like this, we are going to create the PHP code. Echo, I am just giving a heading H1. And here, let's say, conditional statements and iterative statements for each loop. Yes. Now here again we are going to see an example for each. So here we will see example of color. Color example using array. So it's a new and very beautiful concept of for each, which we are going to see here. Here I'm just defining a variable color. Just go through the content. After that I will explain you it very nicely. So don't worry about it. I will explain each and everything properly. In array, the index starts with 0. I have already taught these things in the array topic. So you know it very well that the index, the first position of the array is always 0. And the last element of the array is always size minus 1. So I hope these things are clear to you. And now I have just created an array here. And yes, now we have created an array. Now for each, I'm going to use for each, and here we are going to use this like this. Color is the name of our array as value. If we want to print the values, we can use it like this first of all. And then what is the next thing which will happen in this particular file? We have to give the statements, and we are just going to print the values of this array. So we are going to use echo and the variable value which we have declared inside. We have declared inside the for each loop. Now I'm just going to run this file on the VAM server. This is the new file, file 17, and now you can see red, blue, green, and so on. If we want to put some br, we can use it like this. So I hope you are getting the things clear and you are not having any problem in it. Let's put some font tag here. Say font color equals to blue and size equals to say 12 or say 24, and then we want to close it. And like this. red, blue, green, yellow, brown. So what we have done here, we have just created an array, and array, the name of array is color. Whenever we want to use a loop, we use for do while or while loop, we are having the option of using for each loop. For each loop works directly on the values. As you can see here, we are just giving the name of the array, no condition, no initialization, and we are just printing the values of array directly in whichever format we want. As we have seen, if you remember, we have seen that video in which I have taught array, we use var dump function to print the array. But when we are trying to print the name of the array directly, it was not working. So we are having this particular option for printing them properly in whatever format, wherever we want. I hope you are getting the concept. If you are having any question, any query, any confusion regarding this particular file, regarding this particular question, or any other program whichever I have taught in my video lectures, then you are free to ask. You just drop your queries into the comment box. If you are enjoying this series, then please like and always share. Sharing always helps to increase the knowledge. And if you are new to this channel, I recommend you to please subscribe FameWorld Educational Hub and also press the notification bell, because after pressing the notification bell, you start getting the notifications of my latest uploads. This channel is for all the computer lovers, because you are at the right place if you are a computer lover. This channel consists of a lot of videos on computer science and information technology. The stuff here would be accurate and most helpful if you are a BTech, BCA or MCA student, because all the content is regarding to the subjects which you study in your content. O-level, CCC, C++, Java, PHP, web designing and many more series are available in the playlist sections. If you haven't watched them yet, I recommend you to please watch those series, and don't forget to check out the playlist section, because it would be much beneficial and helpful for your career, for you to enhance your knowledge free of cost. And I always recommend you to please, I ask you, please practice the code whenever you watch any video, because by sitting back watching the video is not much helpful. Whenever you watch a video, just try that code onto your system, and if you get some error, just try to remove those errors, because errors are very helpful. Whenever we get errors make us conscious. Second thing, try to make some changes into the code and see what are the results. Then you will feel very glad and you will feel that you are learning some new things. So I always want you to learn new things, and please support me by subscribing the channel and sharing. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. See you into the next video.